Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. Today I am so happy to bring you a review of a couple books that I just received in the mail last week. They were sent to me from the publisher Get Creative 6, and I didn't know they were coming. I was very, very pleasantly surprised. And these are the new books by Jane Davenport. So if you're familiar with Jane Davenport's work, you know she does very lovely fashion inspired illustrations of women. It's just gorgeous, whimsical, beautiful work. And she came out with Beautiful Faces, this book, I think a couple years ago. My friend Kathy got me this for my birthday last year, and it was just delightful. But I have to say, this new book, Fabulous Figures, is even better. So if you like Beautiful Faces, I think you're gonna love Fabulous Figures because it touches on everything. So I'm gonna flip through, and I'm also gonna link down below to Amazon because there's a really good look inside of this book. But what I really love about the book and the way she lays it out is, well, for one, the photography is just enticing. I mean, you just wanna pour over the photos in here because, I mean, look at that. It's just so gorgeous, and it just inspires you to play. She really encourages you to use what you have and to make your own swatch list for the materials that you have, so you can see what the stuff you already have does. So you can use what you have first, and then if something that she's using entices you, then you can always add to your collection later. She has developed this principle of breaking the figure down using hearts, and I thought that was really genius. It's really simplified, and I think anybody could follow along with this regardless of if you have a lot of training in drawing or not. And I like how accessible she's making figure drawing to everybody, whether you want to go to a life drawing class, which I love going to life drawing groups, but it's not available to everybody. You can't find them in every location, and it's a little intimidating to go into a life drawing group and start sketching the nude figure. This gives you a lot of information, really good, I want to say, exercises that you can put into practice right away, and a lot of different options so that you'll be able to draw what's in your imagination. I have a bad habit of relying on being able to having to look at something, like either from a life drawing class, looking at a model, or looking at a photograph, and I like how her techniques allow you to draw from memory a little bit more, because there are some formulas and principles that you can apply. And I just really love the way that she set it up, and she showed you how to adapt your heart shapes for, like, an average person, a more voluptuous person, a child, you know, depending on what sort of, you know, frame you're trying to build. She has beautiful examples, a lot of step-by-step illustrations, step-by-step demonstrations, and one that was really fun that I just had to absolutely try as soon as I saw it was drawing with water. And I've done this technique with flower petals before, but never with a figure. And so she has you draw the torso with water, and then you drip your paint into it, and you drag out your legs and your arms. Well, I love the idea so much that I went to town making these fun little fashion figures, and then I just cut them apart and I laminated them and made them into little bookmarks, because I thought they'd be really fun to make and share. But I mean, it was just, they were just so much fun, and you know, you could just fill pages and pages of these little whimsical people, and that's what I did, and it was a ball. So I thought these would be fun for, like, my daughters to hand out to their friends at their summer formal dance where they're all in their fancy outfits and stuff, but I just something fun, and something fun to do with it, I thought. But the exercises are a lot of fun. If you like Beautiful Faces, I think you're going to love this book. The only thing I was concerned with, because I was considering purchasing this and I didn't expect it to arrive in my mailbox, I was worried that if I got this, I would be so in love with her work that everything I do would look just like her. And I don't want to rip off another artist. You know, obviously, that's not what I want to do. But I definitely think you can apply these principles and create drawings that are completely your own style, you know. But it's a nice just foundation to be able to lay things out in. I just like how the way she just shows you how to adapt for different sizes, gives you ideas on how to use mixed media supplies, and the even hands. She broke down hands and feet to be easy. And that's, like, that has got to be the hardest thing, doing your hands and feet. You can have a beautiful figure, and then you end up with these great big, you know, claw paws that look completely out of place. And she really gives you a simplified way to make them look elegant. And her work does have a whimsical elegance to it. And I think that's why so many of us love her work, because it's just so innocent and charming and takes us back to, you know, being high schoolers flipping through fashion magazines. At least that's what I, that's the first time I saw her work, that's what I thought of. I'm like, oh, it's just like, you know, being 15 again and flipping through a fashion magazine. So I really recommend this if you've struggled with drawing figures. It's a very simplified approach, and I really think it could benefit anybody that's struggling with drawing. She also has an e-course. So because, you know, I've been painting for decades, I could grab this book and go right with it and really just apply all the skills very easily. If you feel like you need a little more guidance, like you'd like Jane to help you along the way, she does have an e-course at janedavenport.com. It either just opened or is opening in a few days. So if you feel like you just want a little extra support while you're going through this program, try her course. I haven't personally taken her workshops, but I've heard wonderful things from other students. And I also wanted to review Whimsical Girls, which is kind of like, it's kind of like an art journal with all the hard work done and all the fun bits left to fill in, or an adult coloring book that's really artsy. I absolutely think this is just fantastic. I don't know how she comes up with all these ideas. I really don't. But she has different types of paper in this book. She goes over your materials like she does in all of her books. But what I like is that she's got some of her these illustrations done on like a smooth coloring paper, like you would use your markers or your colored pencils. So you could collage on them, you can color on them. And so your coloring, they're probably the easiest things to do. Use your probably water-based markers and colored pencils. And then as you work through, you get some craft paper pages where you might want to use, well, colored pencils would work really good on this. And of course you can collage and, you know, keep layering up just like you would in an art journal. And then she's got some watercolor pages towards the end, so you could get out your juicier mediums and, you know, really have fun with it. And you could flip around and work on whatever page you want, just like you would in your own art journal or your own like adult coloring book. These pages have perforations on them, so if you really love the page that you've colored and collaged, you could frame it and hang it up. I'm not sure. Let's see. It looks like they're all perforated, which I think is really fun because you could make your own artwork for your home. It alternates with like a page with some color on it and a black and white page, so you can collage and layer and just build and have a good time. It's kind of like an art journal that already has a little bit of a framework in it. So if you've ever watched any of Jane Davenport's videos, a lot of times you'll see her pull out her art journal to show a technique, and she'll be working over a page that she's already had some paint on it that she's already played on, and then she gets to add to that, and it just looks so great to see those layers. Well, she's done that in this book so that you can kind of jump in at the fun part. You can get past the, oh my gosh, it's a white page, I'm scared of the white page, because I think it's kind of intimidating when you're looking at a white page, because it could be anything. All the possibilities there, and then you have choice overwhelm because you don't know where to go. Here, you've got a little bit of guidance. You've got something down on the paper so that you can build from it, so it's not so intimidating. The artwork is beautiful, and I think it's a lot of fun. This is probably not one that I was going to buy, but seeing it, I could definitely see myself coloring in this and having a great time. I know my daughters would definitely love to see this out on the coffee table next to a box of colored pencils, because they would dig right in too. So both of them are wonderful. I don't know if both of them will be suited to you or not, but I wanted to give you a good overview of what they were in case you were curious. I thought this might have been an instruction. It's not. This one is not an instructional book. This is more of like an adult coloring book / partially done art journal. It's kind of like a cross between an adult coloring book and a Wreck This journal. But the thing I do like about this is that the spaces are bigger. I'm not a big fan of the adult coloring books with the teeny tiny little spaces. I'm not fussy. I like to go wild. And this is definitely would be like a type of adult coloring book that I would absolutely love. I'll probably bring this with me when I go to a stamp show later on this month. We've got a lot of traveling to do. So I'll probably bring this with me and some supplies, and I might even pass this off to my girlfriends who I'm traveling with and let us all work in this book. I think it would be just a ball. But this, oh my goodness, I recommend this to anybody that's a fan of Jane Davenport's work, that wants to get better at figure drawing and isn't very, even if you are experienced at it, it just gives you a new perspective on how to lay out that figure. I usually, when I'm sketching a figure, like if I was sketching like a person, I would try to find try to find some lines that I could kind of get that line in there, get some gesture and try to like tie things together that way. The heart technique does the same thing. It does tie things together. It's just a different way to do it. It's a different way to skin that cat. And I think the more techniques you can learn, the better off you're going to be, because every situation you're sketching is going to be a little bit different. I think that she knocked it out of the park with this book. I would definitely say go and get this if you love her work. This one, I would say get this if you like to work on something that's kind of, if you want that little bit of hand-holding along the way when you're doing your art journal, because it does give you that foundation that you can build on. This is not going to be for everybody because, you know, if you already have a strong idea of what you want to put on a page, having stuff already done may make you feel a little bit like a cheater, or it may hinder you. So that's why I really wanted to flip through there and show you what it is, because I know some people are going to love it, and for other people, it's not going to be for them. I did not check out this listing on Amazon to see if they had a look inside. They usually do, but I'll link up to both of these as well as her original book here, which is just lovely. This book, I would sit down and drink a cup of tea and sit on the porch and read this book when my kids are all playing. This book, I tried to sit down and read this with a glass of wine, and I couldn't. I had to get up and go to my art table and start painting little figures that I turned into bookmarks, because I was just so inspired that I had to jump out of my chair and get my art supplies. So next time I read a little more of this book, I'm going to have my my tablet with me that I can sketch on, so I can sketch along while I'm watching, because it's just so good. It's so good. I want to thank the publishers for sending me this book. You can find it, I'm not sure if it's in all of your local bookstores yet, but I'm sure it'll be in all your major bookstores. And I highly recommend it. I want to thank them for sending it to me. Thank you guys for watching today. I hope you found it useful. And until next time, happy crafting!